Assalamu alaikum. Peace be upon the master of martyrs and peace be upon you adorers. Welcome to Shia Waves. I'm your anchor Ali Jassim here to present and replenish your minds with the latest Shia world news. And now with the headlines.
Grand Ayatollah Sayyid Shirazi says Iraq will achieve victory by its faith and by following the directives of the religious authority. Imam Rida's biography translated into Armenian. Quran memorization competition held in Rwanda.
A group of teachers and students of the Hawza of Imam al-Kadhim, peace be upon him, from the holy city of Najaf, have visited the Grand Ayatollah Sayyid Sadiq Husseini Shirazi, may Allah prolong his life, in his honorable house in the holy city of Qum, where they listened to his valuable instructions. His Eminence pointed out that people in Iraq and the Muslim world need to be strong and patient to make the future Iraq better with the blessings of the Ahlul Bayt, peace be upon them. His Eminence asserted that the corruption will fade away by following the path of the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, and his progeny, who is the master of our imams, peace be upon them all, adding that the salvation of Iraq means the salvation of the whole world. Iraqi army soldiers and volunteers troops have recaptured over a dozen villages by pushing back the ISIL terrorists in the east. The soldiers launched mop-up operations in the province of Diyala and managed to drive the terrorists out of 16 villages there. The army also defused explosive devices planted by Takfiri ISIL terrorists following clashes which killed more than 100 of them. According to reports, the soldiers captured 24 vehicles from the ISIL. Human rights groups in Bahrain have strongly condemned the United Kingdom's recent decision to increase the sale of arms to Bahrain. The rights groups added that serious concerns are raised that the escalating arms trade and deepening of military ties between the UK and Manama government are bent on suppressing the democratic will of its people. The groups pointed out that the UK government is not just silent in the face of Bahrain's ongoing human rights abuses, it is actively enabling repression by whitewashing the regime and giving it practical and moral support with arms sales. Prominent Kashmiri Shiite leader and politician Maulvi Iftikhar Hussain Ansari passed away today in Indian capital New Delhi. Ansari had been shifted to New Delhi Hospital after being diagnosed with liver cancer. Maulvi Ansari had succeeded his father Maulvi Muhammad Jawad as president of Al Jammu and Kashmir Shiite Association in 1962. He was earlier a member of the National Conference and Congress. He was the vice president of the People's Democratic Party. More than 200 people have been arrested after violence erupted between Hindus and Muslims in the Indian state of Gujarat. According to reports, the clashes began in the city of Vadodara after a distorted image offended Muslims on social media. The state authorities responded by blocking mobile internet and text messaging to prevent further escalation of the conflict. After several days of violence, during which the two sides threw stones at each other and one person was stabbed, the police have arrested more than 200 people from both communities. According to an Indian official, the man guilty of starting the riots was a teacher who posted a controversial message on WhatsApp. He has since been arrested. Gujarat is mostly populated by Hindus, while Muslims constitute a minority. In 2012, over 1,000 people, mostly Muslims, were killed during religious riots. The thoughts of the 8th Shiite Muslim Imam, Imam Rida, peace be upon him, have been published in Armenian. The book is entitled With You to Heaven and includes the biography and sayings of Imam Rida, peace be upon him. It was published by the Vaskan Erevansi Publishing House. A national competition on the memorization of the Holy Quran was held in Rwanda. According to reports, 50 male and female memorizers of the Holy Quran participated in the competition. The categories of the competition included the memorization of the entire Quran and memorization of 2, 5, 10, or 20 parts of the Holy Book. Islam is practiced by about 5% of the total population of the African country, according to the 2006 census. The number of Muslim children in several British cities is fast eclipsing that of Christian children, according to birth rate statistics that reveal the country's significant demographic change. The Daily Mail reports that the latest statistics extracted from the 2011 census shows that from the 275,000 young people in Britain's second largest city, Birmingham, 97,000 registered as Muslim compared to 94,000 as Christian. Meanwhile, in Bradford, 52,000 children, forming 45% of the total, are Muslim compared to the 47,000 Christians. The London Borough of Tower Hamlets has the biggest difference, with 62% of children being raised Muslim. Christians in Boro are significantly outnumbered by 35,000 to just 9,000. We have reached the end of our news show. Thank you all for joining in with us, and as always, remember our dua to hasten the reappearance of our beloved Imam Mahdi, peace be upon him. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.